Hello, everybody. This is Dr. McBrick, and I wanted to let you know that we are working on our Lego city, and we are making things happen. For now, what I've done is I have built a temporary setup. At the moment, we are going to be building out our part of our basement. I'm building out a room down there, about 20 by 20. There's a nice bright egress window in the basement there, so it'll provide some nice natural lighting. But for now, until that room gets built sometime by the end of spring, I've set up a temporary station up here in the loft, about three stories up from the basement, for our Lego city, just to kind of line up the modulars, see what we have. Now, we have many more constructions, mocks and other types of things, but they're obviously not out here. We only have three of the IKEA tables set up. Once we get the big room done, we're going to buy many, many more of these IKEA tables and set them up. I just put all these modulars together just to see what we had and what we're up against. The layout of the real city, once we get it started, will actually be much more detailed, obviously, and it will also have a different configuration of buildings, so it'll be much more interesting to look at as opposed to just one long line. A couple of things about the city here. What we're trying to do is we're going to use this just as an experimentation place. We're going to, in that green spot over there, we're going to build a parking lot. This will probably transfer to the permanent module or to the permanent model of the city. We're going to build a parking lot because the assembly square, you know, we all know, for those of us that have it and have seen it, the sides and the backs are absolutely ugly, especially assembly square. For some reason, it's really ugly on the sides and the back. So we're using the best side of assembly square, and where the green spot is, we're going to make a nice parking lot. A nice parking lot with a nice rock wall around it. It'll have a nice walkway and things like that. And then we're going to build and put some billboards on the side of the building, as you would see in a city. And maybe a billboard advertising a business here in town, that sort of thing. So yeah, so we're going to be building that. We're just going to leave it sit there and figure out how that's done. I just finished it on the CAD program, and we'll see how that goes. So anyway, the other thing we're going to use this temporary setup for is we are going to build roads, and we're not going to buy the Lego roads. You know, they're nice and all, but the fact that you have to buy one pack just to get one straight or one curve, and then you get that intersection piece, to me does not make much sense. And it's a lot of waste and a lot of money. So I figured out, oh, there's a guy painting. Yeah, I guess he's fixing it up. Anyway, so I figured out that what we're going to do, we looked at some YouTubers, namely Rubrik and This Old Brick, and we really loved how they built their roads. So we're going to try to copy that style, you know, with all due respect, and use that style because we think it's a lot more classy in terms of roads. So we're going to be putting those roads all along here. And then at the front of the road, kind of at the front of the table here for this temporary setup, we'll have some sort of nice walkway and path and nature and stuff like that. So we're really just going to use this temporary setup for experimentation, to experiment with road textures, trees, hills, rivers, bridges, and definitely some rock work and things like that. And then we'll transfer it to a larger city once we get the room built downstairs in the basement and everything. Right next to the diner is actually going to be a mock that we have been waiting to build for, oh my goodness, 18 years? And I say that and I'm not exaggerating. My older boys and I, when they were little kids, they're grown men now, and when they were little kids, we designed an auto repair shop. We're all car fans. As a matter of fact, we have a 1968 Mustang in the family. I got it when I was 17 years old, and it's been in the family for, geez, oh, Pete's, 30 years. My son has it now. And so we're car people, and we decided to design this car repair shop. Well, we designed it, and we mocked it up and everything like that back in 2000. And I finally placed a brick order today, we are going to get all of the bricks to actually complete. And it'll be right next to the diner, Smitty's auto repair, and it's going to be pretty cool. It's a 50s style kind of porcelain looking white building, so it'll fit really nice with this diner. And it's kind of open and everything, so the side of the diner staircase here, you'll still be able to see and appreciate and everything like that once we get our real town built. But Smitty's Auto Repair is going to be built. It cost quite a bit to do the bricks, to buy all the bricks, but you know what? It cost just about as much as any of these modulars, actually cost more than a lot of these modulars, to get Smitty's Repair Shop built with the BrickLink order. But you know what? It's worth it, and it's kind of an homage to my kids and myself when back in the day when we were building and we had our big Lego town. So I will probably do a video with kind of the drawings and stuff like that and the renderings of Smitty's Repair Shop, so you can all see it here. But anyway, so that's what's happening. We have a temporary town. It's nothing special. All it is a bunch of modulars lined up and stuck together. No big deal, people, but we are going to be building it, and I will be giving videos and making videos and stuff like that as we go along. Building it every week. So you'll see the roads come along, you'll see parking lots, you'll see parks, and it'll start to develop. And then once the big room gets built downstairs, then we have so much more building to do. All right, that's about all. Dr. McBrick, signing out.